let's go.
Hold on. I have an hour and 14 minutes on my movie.
Oh, hi. Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, of course, ma'am. We came as soon as we got your note. We definitely didn't wait an hour and 14 minutes. Your mom said to watch you, but you don't do anything. Oh, that is lowbrow. It's funny as shit, but it's lowbrow. Hey, Pigeon! Is that the same guy from on Golden Pond?
I don't know. What are you watching?
Fast and the Furious 3. No, wait. Jaws 3. No, wait. On Golden Pond.
Yeah. It's the same guy.
Did any of you hear that? Please tell me someone heard it.
What the fuck, Marcus?
She heard the sound.
Oh, damn. I'm sorry. I thought I let that one out quietly. Well, I had a head of cabbage for breakfast, okay?
I swear to God, I'm gonna lose my mind.
It's okay, ma'am. Let's take the car out on the freeway, and we'll all be real quiet, and we'll all pay attention. No screens, guys, okay? Everybody put away your screens. Away.
Dad, you're the only one watching a movie. Hello?
Ah! What is that?
Can you believe how loud this shit is? It's the worst thing in the world, man. I keep thinking this lady's crazy, like she was making this shit up because of fucking depressed life. But it's not that. It's real.
What are we gonna do? I don't think I can take it much longer.
Neither can I.
Oh my... My minivan!
Maybe this little screaming gnome that was trapped in your car knew what the sound was. Deezy, man, would you mind taking off your shoes, man? We become a no-shoe household here.
Oh, not a problem, Mike. You get the carpets clean?
No, I read about all these things people tracking to your house, man, with their shoes. Dirt, urine, vomit, semen, and pollen. Man, I've been sneezing all day.
Wait, you're going to Afghanistan? When?
Right now.
What?
They need to fill the slot. Wayne Brady just dropped out.
Hold up, man. I'm the backup choice to Wayne Brady? That's a huge fucking honor, man. I love Wayne Brady, man. Man, what's that show, man? Who the fuck line is it? Okay, Deezy, we will do it. You can't disappoint the troops. They're expecting improv, and they're getting improv.
But we don't know how to do improv.
That's the beauty of improv. You don't even have to know how to do improv. You just have to improv what's ever in the top of your head.
My God, how many times are you assholes gonna say improv?
You know what we gotta do when we get there? Get them a thank you gift. Yeah, as soon as we get there. What kind of shit they sell in Afghanistan?
I don't know. I think I've heard of an Afghan rug.
What the fuck does Deezy need with an Afghan rug?
Michael, what are you doing?
I think I saw a Radio Shack.
Dad, we need to follow him.
My bad, that ain't a Radio Shack. It's just a shack.
Dad, I'm really starting to get nervous. Can we practice or something?
No, honey, no. I told you, you don't practice improv.
Well, I don't think I can go out there.
Okay, sweetie, I understand. You're not funny. Hey, Pigeon, let's do it. We're the funny ones.
Oh, I'm not doing it.
Okay, cool. Marcus, it's just me and you, dude.
What?
I am Mike Tyson, former heavyweight champion of the world. But the real heavyweight champion of the world are you, the troops. I just came up with that right now. That's how good of an improv I am. Okay, we take you now to a bank.
Good afternoon, sir. Welcome to the bank. I understand you are interested in, taking out a loan?
Michael, say something.
Oh, God. I can't think of anything. My heart is beating 1,000 miles an hour. I'm so nervous. Marcus, use your ghost powers to get us the fuck out of here.
That's her. Okay, she can't know why I've called you here. I mean, what if I'm wrong about all this?
Oh, you're not wrong.
Relax, sir. She won't suspect a thing. Oh, hi, ma'am. I'm Randy. I went to school with your husband. And this is, my sister. And this is our son.
Aren't you Mike Tyson?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh! Ah!
kill these sexual deviants, alien, but you can't kill my friend. Oh, semen!
You're saying my wife was an alien? And now she's just gone back to her home planet? We were married for 7 years. I just can't believe it.
We're so sorry.
Well, I guess as bad as it is, for whatever reason, it makes me feel better to know she wasn't unfaithful.
What are you talking about? She is very unfaithful. I would estimate she slept with anywhere from 1 to 10,000 people. She is probably harvesting sperm for an alien species. Unless she was just doing it for her own personal pleasure. Either way, she is very, very promiscuous.
Dad, you didn't have to tell him that part. Did you guys know it was his birthday? What are we gonna give him?
I don't know. I could give him gonorrhea, but I'd have to fuck him.
I feel like we can do better, but that's a good backup. Okay, read the mystery of the pigeon, honey.
My name is Julie, and I'm a production assistant on The Charlie Rose Show.
The Charlie Rose Show is a talk show on PBS.
I need your help because last night's guest, Greg Popovich, has gone missing. Please hurry.
Hurry means to move or to proceed with haste.
I know. What do you think? I'm a fucking idiot?
I don't know. Don't birds have small brains?
It's like he took 2 steps away and then he was gone.
Maybe he got swallowed up by all that darkness behind the table. I mean, it's pitch black, man. What kind of cheap-ass background is that for a talk show?
Dad.
I'm just saying, man, if Charlie Rose wants to be successful, and if he wants to compete with the Jay Leno's and the David Lettermans of the world...
They got rid of Leno, it's Fallon. And Letterman retired.
Fallon? Who's the other guy?
Oh. Jimmy Kimmel.
That's not the guy I'm talking about. Who am I thinking of?
How the fuck would I know who you're thinking of?
The one with the city in the background, dickhead.
This is a waste of time. We need to be looking for him in places I haven't already looked.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are we the Julie mystery team, or are we the Mike Tyson mystery team? Because last time I checked this tracksuit, it said Mike Tyson mystery team.
No, it doesn't. It just has a question mark.
What? Fucking Deezy. The whole time I thought this said the Mike Tyson mystery team. Is my face at least on the back? Somebody please tell me my face is on the back of this fucking tracksuit.
Yes?
Good, because I was going to kick somebody's fucking ass if my face wasn't on the back of this thing. Fucking question mark my ass. Makes me seem like I'm just walking around like I don't know. Then he got up and went where?
Kill all humans!
Please, promise me you'll carry on in my place.
I will, Charlie. You hear that machine? I will! Timothy Geithner, it has been a pleasure. Thank you for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having me.
I think that man wanted Mike to take his place fighting those machines.
Yeah, but he's doing all right. Hey, he fixed that background.
Tomorrow night, our guest will be New York Times columnist Paul Krugman. Good night, everyone.